Hi everyone, it's Mikey Millions here, and in this episode, we are going to explore one of my new favorite strategies, the put-debit spread. My initial plan was to continue the strategy series with the short strangle and then the iron condor, but with the market tanking the way it has been, neutral strategies just aren't getting it done. How many of you would love to buy some puts right now and make money as stocks crumble, but the premiums are just way too high? At-the-money puts on SPY are going for about $950 with just 3 days to expiration. You want to hang out with the bears, but $950 tickets to the club are just too much for your personal risk tolerance. If that sounds like you, the put debit spread offers a solution. Let's check it out. The put debit spread is technically a bear gang strategy since you're spending premium instead of selling it, but for us conniving but cautious theta gangsters who want to take advantage of collapsing prices, this offers us a good compromise. Even better, put debit spreads don't get destroyed by IV crush like regular old puts do. But that's another benefit that we'll talk about later. The put debit spread is a bearish strategy that involves buying a put and then selling another put at a lower strike price. We spend money to buy a put, which is of course a bet that shares will drop, but we also sell another put at a lower strike. For doing so, we get some of that premium back, which can dramatically reduce the cost of entering a trade. In exchange, that short put will cap our gains, so we won't benefit if the stock goes below that strike. Basically, the put we bought will earn us money until the stock reaches our short strike. After that, we've hit our max gain and we won't benefit from further downside. Let's use the profit and loss chart to illustrate this. Let's say Wall Street Bets is trading at $30. We think it's going to go down quite a bit, but premiums are so expensive, with each at-the-money put going for $3, costing us $300 for a ticket to the bear cave. If we were to enter this trade, our max loss would be the $300 we spent to buy the put, and our max gain would be $2,700 if Wall Street Bets goes to zero. Our break-even would be way down at 27, since we just spent $3 a share to enter the trade. That's a 10% move before we make any money, which is quite the drop. That $2,700 max gain sounds nice, but Wall Street Bets isn't actually going to zero, so it isn't going to happen. But let's say you do expect it to suffer some loss to around $25. Well, if we had just bought that put and Wall Street Bets did go to $25, our put would go from being worth $300 to $500, and we would have made $200. Cool. But we can do better. Let's sell a put in addition to convert to a put debit spread. That will reduce our cost to enter the trade to reduce our max loss, improve our break even, and potentially even score us a bigger profit. We are eyeing $25 as our next Wall Street Bets price, so let's use that target when we convert from a put to a put debit spread. To do this, let's still buy that $30 strike for $300, and then sell the $25 strike for $100. Our profit and loss chart now looks like this. Since we got $100 premium back, our max loss is now only $200. That will also move our break-even from $27 to $28, so we only need Wall Street Bets to drop 6.7% before we make a profit, instead of the 10% drop we would need if we just bought the put. However, we also capped our max gain. If Wall Street Bets drops to $10, we won't get the full benefit of buying a put, since we also sold a put. Our max gain is the distance between strikes minus what we paid to enter the trade. This gives us control to set our max gain. In our example, the max gain would be $500 minus the $200 we spent to open the trade, or $300 max profit. Alternatively, a 30 by 29 trade has a max gain of $100 minus the premium. A 30 by 10 trade has a max gain of $2,000 minus the premium. Let's stick with our 30 by 25 spread for now and run through some examples of how our WSB trade might play out. Let's say expiration rolls around and WSB is trading for $31. Our bet was wrong. If we had bought a put, we'd lose our whole $300 investment since our put expired out of the money. With a put debit spread, the $30 strike we bought will still expire worthless, so we lose $300 there. But we also sold the $25 strike, which also expires worthless and allows us to realize the whole $100 premium. Our loss in this case would balance out to be $200 instead of the full $300. If WSB closes at $27.50, put buyers would see their contracts worth $250, since this is $2.50 in the money. That's $50 less than they paid to buy the put, so put buyers would lose $50. for us put debit spread traders, our $30 strike we bought will still only be worth $250, which is $50 less than what we paid for it. But the $25 strike that we sold also expires out of the money, giving us the full $100 premium. We lost $50 on the $30 strike, but we gained $100 on the short $25 strike. In this case, we would actually gain $50 instead of losing $50 like the put buyers. If Wall Street Bets wound up at $25 like we expected, then put buyers would see their contracts worth $500. That's $200 more than they paid for it, so they make $200 on this trade. For put debit spread traders, our long put is still worth $500, so there's a $200 gain on that leg. But our short put still expires worthless, so we still pull the $100 premium from that leg. That's a $300 gain instead of a $200 gain. And last one, let's say WSB drops to $10. That's $20 in the money for put buyers. So their puts will be worth $2,000 and they'll pull a $1,700 gain. Put debit spread traders will see their long put worth the same, but their short put is now in the money. The short put that we sold for $100 is now worth $1,500. That's a $1,400 loss on the short leg. Once we balance that out with the long leg, we made a $300 gain on this play. Still cool, but far short of that $1,500 the put buyers made. $300 is our max gain no matter what happens to WSB stock. How did that happen? Let's look behind the scenes. If we don't just close out the spread for a gain and instead let it expire, then since we sold the $25 strike, if Wall Street Bets drops below that on expiration, our short put will be in the money and we will be forced to buy 100 shares for $2,500. Of course, we have our $30 put, so we can then sell all 100 shares for $3,500 and make $500 on the spread. However, we paid a total of $200 to enter the spread in the first place, so once we subtract that cost, our effective gain is $300. That's not quite as good as if we had just bought a put and could sell $10 shares for $30 a pop, but that's the risk we run by using put debit spreads instead of buying puts. We can miss out on bigger gains and suffer serious FOMO. On the positive side, we can get a lower cost to enter the trade, and we can get a more favorable break-even. Unless you really expect a stock to drop tremendously by expiration and you're willing to pay a premium to bank on it, then the put debit spread is usually the better choice. Now, let's talk about IV crush, which is what happens when implied volatility drops and premiums start trading dirt cheap. We all know that right before earnings, premiums get nice and fat because the market is expecting a big move. When earnings are released and they're so boring that they don't move the stock, call and put buyers see their contract values crushed. There's no more catalyst. Earnings are gone, so the market is done expecting a big move, and no one wants to pay a high premium for a stock that isn't moving. If you were holding contracts at that point, you should expect a big loss. You are a victim of IV crush. Put debit spreads protect us from some of that IV crush. The put that we bought will still feel the crunch, but the put that we sold will benefit from dropping premiums, so it helps balance things out and protects us from getting nailed. Let's say you expected WSB to drop around earnings, so we placed the same $30 by $25 put debit spread and paid $200 to enter the trade. If the earnings report comes out and WSB only drops to $29.80, IV crush is going to kill the value on both of our legs. On the $30 put that we bought, that will hurt us. But on the $25 put that we sold, that will help us out. We'd still lose some value in this situation since the $30 strike is closer to the market price than the $25 strike, and so it has a higher vega. But the value of the $25 strike getting hammered puts some money back into our pocket, so it helps balance out our loss. Technically, if you set both legs of your spread in the money, you can even gain a little bit from IV crush, since the short leg will be closer to the market price than the long leg, and so it will have a higher vega. However, the benefit would be pretty small, and you're likely to lose more money to theta decay than you'd gain from IV crush. If that sounded a bit like Swahili, just remember this. If you are bearish around earnings and you want to protect yourself from IV crush, use a put debit spread. It'll give you some level of protection, like wearing a mouth guard to a fist fight. If you want to completely protect yourself from IV crush, set both legs of your spread deep in the money. Then you won't have to worry about IV crush at all. That'll help you out tremendously if implied volatility goes way down. With all that in mind, let's go live into the market. I'm here looking at SPY, which is the S&P 500's ETF. So it's been rising through the 11-year bull market. Now, that bull market is over, and I think SPY is going to keep dropping for the next several months. So let's check out the May 1st expiration. If I buy an at-the-money put at the $226 strike, I'd have to pay over $1,700, and I would need a 7.7% drop before I make any money. I'm not cool with that because it's kind of expensive, and I don't think SPY is going to drop another 30% this month anyway. So I'm going to both buy this put and then sell another at a lower strike price to convert to a put debit spread. Let's buy the at-the-money strike for $1,707 premium, and then sell the 215 strike to get $1,322 premium back. That will reduce our cost of laying on this spread to $385 and move our break-even from $208.93 to $222.56. Now, I only need SPY to drop 1.7% instead of a full 7.7% before I become profitable. In exchange, I'm capping my max gain at $715 if SPY goes below $215. That's the $11 distance between my strikes minus the $385 I had to spend to enter this trade. I'm happy with that, and Robinhood agrees that this is indeed a put debit spread. So let's go ahead and place this order for a single contract. Since the market is closed, this trade isn't going to fill now, but I'll look back on Monday morning to see if this trade executed at open. If not, I'll adjust my order until I get a fill. Keep in mind that spreads can also amplify gains. If I were willing to put the full $1,700 on the line, the same cost as buying the long put, but as put debit spreads instead, I could lay on four spreads for the same price as one long put. In that case, if SPY were to drop to 215, our gain would be $2,860. Compare that with put buyers, who would be looking at a $209 break-even price and would still be down $600 if SPY is at 215 on expiration. That difference is what put debit spreads can do for you. As far as when to exit a spread, I recommend closing when you hit your target profit. In this market, it's not uncommon to see a crazy 1,000 point gain on the Dow, which could easily bring your put debit spread from being a 90% gain to 100% loss if it happens shortly before expiration. My exit rules are this: take profit if you gain 25% in an hour, 50% in a day, or 90% overall. I only let my spreads expire to see that 100% gain if both legs are deep in the money. And with the swings we're seeing this month, I might even have to rethink doing that. I encourage you to come up with your own exit rules that meet your personal risk tolerance. Just don't be stubborn trying to get the last $4 of premium left on your spread. Just close out and take your money before you get slaughtered by a Trump tweet. To wrap it all up, I want you to remember this. Put debit spreads are like a discounted ticket to Club Bear. This discounted ticket gets you cheaper entry, better break-evens, and protection from IV crush. Under some circumstances, being able to afford more tickets can actually enhance your profits too. In exchange for these perks, you give up the benefit of making all the money when stocks crash. If stocks continue to crash, then while the bears are driving McLarens, you're driving a Honda, and you have to be okay with that if you're going to use put debit spreads. That's all for this video. I hope you guys see ways to work put debit spreads into your portfolio. Good luck making some cash as the apocalypse strikes, and I hope you and your families all stay safe from the Kung Flu. Have a good week, and I'll see you next time.